Welcome back, my friends, my fellow sensory weirdos. Today is a little bit of a casual video that I thought I would show you some of my pins. I have a pin collection here. And we'll go through and kind of point to them. I'll use my pointer tool and tell you a little bit about them, and it says a lot about me, I think. I don't collect a lot of pins, but if I can't pass one up, or if it's a weird one that I get for free, I'll take it. So, I've been wearing gloves. I tried to purchase some band-aids that were cute. It didn't impress me, honestly. So, I'll have to figure out what I'm going to do about it. First, I'm going to lay them all out flat so we can't see what they are. I think that would be fun. Honestly, I don't ever see them all in one spot either. And I don't think this one is mine. Some of these are my partner's. We've just kind of thrown them in together. But I did take out my political ones because this is just my non-political little spot in my world, so I collect those, mostly just vintage ones. And a lot of these are gifts too. Okay. So, some of these I do know what they are right away, but spread them out a little bit evenly. This one I actually took off of my jacket just recently. There we go. You can see it's Spock from Star Trek. My lighting's not very good there, but he's got his hands up, pensive kind of thinking. And it's a small button. I bought this at a record shop in Lincoln Square in Chicago. I don't remember the name of it, but it's still open. And it came with another one, I believe, but they had a bunch of pins and patches. I think I had to buy some other Star Trek characters that I've lost because I don't, I only really wanted this one. Let's check this one out. Oh, this one isn't. This one isn't mine. It might be my partner's, or it might be from a quarter machine. There's a lot of pins that you can find in little quarter machines around the city at different record shops and coffee shops that are fun. And a lot of the time I don't know what they are, but they're fun to have. This one is my honeybee. Because, actually, I have this to go with it. This is a patch. I just actually, my family is letting me put some bees on their property, and I am really excited about it, and I'm definitely going to incorporate the bees into my ASMR somehow. I can't help myself. I love bees. I bought this, I think I ordered it on Etsy or somewhere for, oh, I bought it at a honey co-op. during a craft sale type thing, craft fair. This one is not mine, this one is my partner's. This is one of my favorites. People kind of either love, hate, or don't understand Tim and Eric, but this is Steve Brule, a character that you recognize it. I can't think of his dang real name, but you know it, and I know it too. But I can't think of it because all I can think of is Steve Brule and Brule's Rules. Because I like that kind of humor. Yeah, Tim and Eric's death is funny. One of my favorite movies with him in it is The Lobster. It's one of my all-time favorite movies. Very, very, very weird, dry humor. Love it. Love it. This one is mine. This one is Rasputin. Rasputin. I don't know how I'm not going to get yelled at if I say it, but Rasputin, Grigory Rasputin. This was at Quimby's bookstore. It's a zine shop in Chicago, very, very much loved one. And I think I got that there. At least that's what comes to the top of my head, but I just find his story really fascinating and bizarre. Really interesting historical time in history. This is also my partner's. I think it was a gift for him. He really likes dinosaurs, which is like from my dinosaur collection, fossil collection video. Those are all mostly his things. But this was a gift, I think, from his bass player. For him. This is Boy George. Not sure which year. I got this at a store on in Belmont back in, I want to say 2001, when I came and traveled to Chicago before I lived here, and I bought one of this pin, and it's been pinned to the back of my little 420 box that I have had since forever, and it's been saved there. I think it's actually it's a little bit vintage anyway. I think I bought it at the Hollywood Mirror or maybe Ragstock back in the day. Here's another beekeeping one. P. Pluribus Unum. Which, gosh, I used to know this. I think it's, I'm not gonna guess. But it's beekeeper stuff, and I used to remember it. But not when it's casual ASMR day. Gives me a license to forget. Now let's check this one out. This one was given to me. My mom went to a place that had a bunch of booths with free stuff, and she gathered up a bunch of stuff that she thought I would like, free stuff. This one is about preventing suicide within LGBTQ community. And this one I bought at an antique store. I have no idea what it means or where it came from. The antique store was in Wisconsin, I believe. And it just was interesting and old, and I liked the style, so I think it was 10 cents. A big Beavis and Butthead fan, so that basically just explains itself. This one also, I think I gave the Butthead one to my partner, or I didn't buy one, I can't remember. This also came from the same bookstore, I mean record shop that I got this one from. This is a local band from Chicago, Satanic Panic. Motor Kitty Rescue is a cat rescue based in Detroit. I bought this when it used to be ran, it might still be, by somehow connected through, I follow Wes Borland, the guitarist from Limp Bizkit on Instagram, and he had this cool kitty cat with these like little lobster claw things, and that's who's back here. So I think I bought my dog a pin, and I bought myself one in the patch, maybe something else. This one, Iron Maiden. This is the other one that just came off of my jacket that usually goes with Spock over here, so usually they're together. IronMaiden with Spock. This one's tricky to get closed. I think I got this one out of a... Oh, I got it from... There was a metal market at 1 year in Logan Square, and they had a couple of different places where you could buy these things for a good price. So this is Gunpowder Grey, a band from Atlanta. I've got a skull. This is Elvira. She's my queen. Like, if I had to choose, like, a queen person, like, people would pick Lady Gaga or whoever is their queen. RuPaul, maybe, but... actually, her. There's a meme that I saw where it was, like, in the style of a... and something about religion with Elvira being the dark and Dolly Parton being the light, and I thought that was the perfect balance for me because I think Dolly is a perfect human being, and I think Elvira is the also perfect equal side of that human being, just in my mind, their character anyway. I'm a big Elvira fan. You've probably seen in my other videos, I've got a bunch of Elvira stuff. I even got a custom signed Elvira DVD. This is a gift from one of my friends. It was so funny. She got this from a local place too. I don't remember where, but this is, if you play The Sims, or if you played The Sims, the original Sims, this was the cheat to get money. Like old school kind of secrets. I've been playing The Sims since I was, I don't know, 12 or 13. Like the original, when it came out, I was hooked. Might do a Sims video someday. And last but not least, this is one of my favorites because it is Stick Stickley. If you were a kid in the 90s, Stick Stickley was pretty pretty cool. He had a song that went with this. If you know the song, you're already singing it, but I'll give you a little ditty here. First of all, Stick Stickly was a popsicle stick with Google eyes and like a clay nose and mouth, and it was around the same time when that was really popular, like that pizza guy from Pizza Hut, the oh no, that guy, whatever. Anyway, so the song went, write to me, Stick Stickly, P.O. Box 963, New York City, New York State, 10108. And, I wonder what happens if you write there now. I've been tempted, honestly, just because the song creeps in sometimes. Don't sing it too much because it will stick. So, that's pretty much the collection. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. So, some of them aren't mine, but that's okay. I think if I had to put them in order of how much I love them, it would be, let's see, these ones aren't mine, so it's at the bottom. Maybe not love, but the ones that I wear most, I'll go with that. The only reason I don't wear some of these is because they're either close to breaking or they fall off really easy and I'm afraid to lose them. So I keep them like on a cork board instead so I can still enjoy them. Like this one, I don't wear it because it would hurt me too much. These are the ones you're most likely to find me wearing. These two go on a cork board. I wear this one too sometimes. And these ones aren't mine, but these are. I've had this on my jacket for a really long time. But I had to move it out of the way because it was a larger size. I usually wear about two at a time. It's been my very casual pin collection. Thanks for watching. It's fun to like put together things into collections because I never think I have collections. I just have a bunch of random crap. So when I think of videos, I start actually organizing. Like as I would find these when I would be cleaning, I'd put them all together so that I could do a video. It's organizing my life.